The scene viewport is the main working space. It shows the view of the world from a virtual camera selected. The scene viewport consists of the following main elements: the viewport itself, the camera panel, the rendering debug panel, the navigation panel, and the Viewcube. Navigation in the scene viewport is simple. Holding down the right mouse button at any time within the scene view will switch the editor into fly-through mode. In the fly-through mode, we can move the mouse to change camera's direction, and we can use W, A, S, D key to move around, and Q and E keys to change our height. Holding the Alt key, we can drag to rotate around the current point of focus. By default, the focus point is the camera itself. We can choose the point of focus by selecting any node and choosing Edit, Focus, or just pressing the F key. If we hold the Alt key and the right mouse button, we can drag to zoom in and out. Rotating the mouse wheel forward and backward does the same. Now we have our focus on this object and can rotate around it. Holding down the Alt key and dragging with the middle mouse button pressed, we can pan the camera. You've probably noticed this cube in the top right corner rotating together with the camera. It is the View Cube, which displays the current direction of the camera and lets you control it. Cameras support perspective and orthogonal projections. We can change the projection using this little icon near the View Cube. Now we don't have the perspective distortion, and all the sizes are equal regardless of the distance. We can switch back to perspective projection the same way. At the top right corner, you'll find the navigation panel that allows to control the camera speed and position. The left part of the panel controls camera speed. Now it's set to 2 units per second, but if we increase it, the camera moves away faster. There are 3 speed presets available. You can change all of them. They're mapped to corresponding number keys at the top of the keyboard. 1, 2, and 3. So we can quickly switch between the speed presets. The right part of the navigation panel displays the coordinates of the current camera position. We can set it up precisely by entering the values of X, Y, and Z coordinates. In the top left corner of the viewport, there is the camera panel. We can choose the current camera by selecting an item in the drop-down list, or just switch between the available cameras by rotating the mouse wheel over it. The next control with the gear icon toggles the camera settings window. Let's change the current camera position, switch to the second one, and then back to the first. Nothing has changed. It is due to the lock enabled, so the locked camera will preserve its transformation. When a camera is unlocked, its transformation changes. The plus button creates a new camera with the current position and direction, and appends it to the world hierarchy. We can create as many cameras as we need. The last button toggles the flashlight, the light source attached to the camera. You can use it to view the scene that has no other light sources. You can also change flashlight settings when necessary. Available settings include intensity, color, attenuation, and others. Rendering debug dropdown enables you to view the temporal buffers of the rendering sequence, providing a huge help in visual debugging. We can view almost any component of the final rendering image. We can hide the scene viewport window and bring back the hidden one. UNIGINE supports limitless number of scene viewports, so you can use as many viewports as you need. Thus, we can access different nodes simultaneously, even if they're located far away from each other. Take note that performance decreases when a new viewport is opened. So when the viewport is no longer needed, don't forget to remove it via window menu option. So you can see how easy it is to navigate within the UNIGINE's virtual world.